Hi everybody, you are welcome to this channel and I am Atanu Betal and in this video lecture we discuss about ionic radius. You know ionic radius is studied in periodic table chapter. In the class 11 and 12 the ionic radius or throughout chemistry the ionic radius is very important part and we have to understand that what is ionic radius. So I am making this video on the part of ionic radius. This is a video lecture where fully we discuss about the ionic radius. Okay, so look at this picture. Ionic radius is defined as the distance, the effective distance between the center of the ion means the nucleus is situated, the center of the ion and the distance where the ionic bonding is present. Ionic bonding is present or ionic bond attraction, ionic bond formation area up to the ionic bond formation area from the center of the atom is called the ionic radius of the ion. Ionic radius of the ion, that may be the cation radius, that may be an anion radius, that is called the ionic radius. For example, I am drawing this picture here for the sodium chloride ionic compound. For ionic compound, ionic radius is meaningful, and for sodium chloride, I am drawing this formation process or the ionic radius showing process of sodium chloride. That in case of sodium chloride, sodium atom is surrounded by chloride atom. Chloride atom, this one is sodium atom and this one is chlorine. This one is chlorine ion, means Cl minus ion, and this one is Na plus ion. Na plus ion. So here the distance between these two means ionic interaction, ionic bond formation area and the center of the atom is called the radius of sodium plus ion, which is 95 picometer, and the radius of the anion, that is chloride ion, Cl minus ion, it is totally a Cl minus ion. So distance between these two is 181 picometer and it is called radius of the anion. And the internuclear distance is these two, means if we make sum of these two, 95 picometer and 181 picometer, then we get the 276 picometer. It is the total means sum of the radius of cation and radius of anion. We can separately write it as radius of cation and radius of anion for sodium chloride is 276 picometer, and the individual radius of sodium plus ion is 75 picometer. It is R or Na plus is 95 picometer, and the radius of Cl minus is 181 picometer. Okay, so from this equation we can get the radius of any other atom. If we know the radius of one atom, other atom can easily be calculated from this equation. So this is the concept of ionic radius. Ionic radius is the distance between the center of the nucleus to the effective area where ionic bonding is present, up to the area where ionic bonding is present. So this is called ionic radius. And in the ionic radius part, you find the cationic radius, anionic radius, and so you discuss about that topic, that cationic radius and anionic radius. We are erasing this topic. You understand it well. I think you understand it. And next, our discussion point is radius of cation and radius of anion. Radius of cation, radius of, or you can say ionic radius of cation is smaller than parent atom. If we talk about the radius of sodium plus and sodium, then the radius of sodium plus is smaller than sodium atom. Radius of cation is always smaller than the parent atom. Why? Because cation is formed by losing electron. So when an atom loses electron, that time its nuclear charge is same, but number of electron decreases. Here in both the cases, compare the number of proton. Here the number of proton is 11 and number of electrons are only 10. But here in case of sodium, number of proton is 11 and number of electron present in the sodium metal, it is 11. So we can see the number of proton is more compared to the number of electron here. So here the nucleus or protons present in nucleus attract the remaining 10 electrons more tightly, and as a result the distance of the center to the effective ionic bonding distance is decreasing here in case of sodium plus, because of the more tight attraction by more number of proton compared to less number of electron. So for this reason, the radius of cation always should be smaller than its parent atom. It is for each and every atom and ion is possible. It is true that the radius of cation should be lesser than the radius of the neutral atom. For the next case, we see about the radius of an anion. Anion is negatively charged species. Anion is greater, not smaller, it is greater. Radius of anion is greater than the parent atom. For example, if we think about the Cl minus and Cl, here the radius of Cl minus is greater than radius of chlorine, okay? Because look at the proton number and electron number in each cases. Here proton number is 17, electron number is 18, and here proton number is 17 and electron number is 17. So we can say the number of proton is lesser than number of electron here. So due to the lesser number of proton that is present in the species Cl, and equal number of proton and electron in Cl, but in Cl minus anion, here the number of proton is lesser than number of electron. So for that reason, this number of proton cannot attract the 18 electrons more firmly or more tightly, or you can say effective nuclear charge decreases in case of Cl minus ion. And for this reason, the Cl minus ion have greater in size compared to the neutral parent atom, chlorine atom, where the size is smaller than the Cl minus ion. So in this way, the size of cation and size of anion depended on the parent atom, okay? Next important point is the oxidation state. This ionic radius is dependent on oxidation number or oxidation state of the element. For example, if the element have higher oxidation number, then the higher oxidation number means lesser ionic radius. Higher ON means oxidation number equal to smaller ionic radius. For elements that have higher oxidation number or the ions that have higher oxidation number, in that case the smaller ionic radius will be seen to us. So for this case, higher oxidation number, smaller ionic radius. And if If oxidation number is same, as for example, Fe2 plus iron, then cobalt 2 plus and nickel 2 plus. Look at this ions here, all the ions have same similar oxidation state, oxidation number 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus, but the nuclear charge is greater here. Here the proton increases from iron to cobalt and nickel. So for this reason, the ionic radius of Fe2 plus is greater than the ionic radius of cobalt 2 plus and nickel 2 plus. Ionic radius decreases in this order, ionic radius decreases because number of protons in nucleus increases, or nuclear charge increases here. Okay, with increase of nuclear charge, ionic radius decreases. Nuclear charge increase equal to nuclear charge increase equal to ionic radius decrease. Here ionic radius decreases with increase of nuclear charge. Okay. Now we consider or discuss some isoelectronic ions, about some isoelectronic ions. Some isoelectronic ions, like size of isoelectronic ion, size of isoelectronic ions, like sodium plus, magnesium 2 plus, and aluminium 3 plus. We have to arrange these ions in increasing order of their size. So in this time we have to find that which ion is larger in size compared to the other. So for this reason, the useful process is, proton is here 11, here proton is 12, and here the proton is 13, and number of electron here 11, sorry 10, here number of electron 10 and number of electron 10. So here these are called isoelectronic ions, because all the ions have equal number of electrons, means 10 electrons for all the ions. So therefore it is called isoelectronic ions. And for isoelectronic ions, that we are seeing that for the case of sodium plus, the number of proton and number of electron 11 10. So out of the 10 electron, in each case 10 electrons are present, but in this case the proton is more, means proton is more than means 3 protons are more than the number of electrons. And for this reason, here the nuclear charge should be higher enough, nucleus attract the electron pair more tightly, and for this reason here the radius is the smallest one, ionic radius is the smallest one, because number of proton is higher here compared to number of electron, and the ionic radius decreases from aluminium to sodium. So ionic radius is greater in case of sodium plus, because here the number of proton and electron difference is less compared to number of proton electron difference is in magnesium 2 plus, and then the number of electron proton difference in aluminium 3 plus, where the maximum proton and electron difference present. So for this reason, here increase of nuclear charge causes the size of atom, size of ion to decrease. So for this reason, the ionic size decreases as sodium plus to magnesium plus, then aluminium 3 plus. So for case of isoelectronic ion, we have to consider the number of proton and number of electrons that are present in each of the ionic species, means isoelectronic species. and if we find that number of proton is more compared to electron, that time the attraction of the proton is more magnitude of positive charge means more attraction more pull towards the nucleus, and as a result the size of atom decreases. Size of ion decreases with increase in the magnitude of nuclear charge. So this is the discussion's topic about the ionic radius of cation, anion, and this is the full discussions. I think you understand this discussion fully, or if you have any problem for understanding this discussion, then you can write your problem or your thinking in the comment sections, that what you are thinking regarding this class, your problem regarding this class. I will certainly read your comment. Thank you for watching this video again, and if you find this video is useful, then give a like to this video, and if you find that this channel is useful, because I am already uploading the various videos from various chapters like atomic structure, chemical bonding. These are very important chapter in chemistry, and you know, for 11-12 class these concepts are very important. So therefore you can watch all the other videos from the playlist that I made, a suitable playlist for chapter wise and for class wise. So from that playlist you can watch all the videos regarding the chemistry topic, and if you find these videos are useful, then you can subscribe this channel.